Hi everyone, I'm Gary from Second Property Investor. Recently helping one of my clients to plan his purchase after cashing out from his previous home. Let me show you how I analyze something for his purchase today. Today we are looking at Claiborne by UOL. It is a 640 units located at Clementi Avenue 1. It consists of 1 to 5 bedroom and the expected TOB date is September 2024. I'm going to use 4 factors to analyze the 4 bedroom units in Claiborne to see is it worth buying. First factor, supply of the 4 bedroom in this location. Understanding the supply will give you a winning edge to see how many competitors we have along the way. You also don't want to buy something that everywhere you go you are able to see it, right? When I'm scrolling down Property Guru, available 4 bedroom in the market that is 1 kilometer away from Clementi MRT, there is only 21 units available for sale currently. And guess what? Some of them are repeated advertisements. If you zoom into individual development, what I can find is Clement Canopy having total of 80 units of 4 bedroom, Trilink 92 units, and for Park Clementis, it has a little bit more, 203 units. So for Claiborne itself, 107 units of 4 bedrooms. Compared to other room type, I think the supply is still considered low. Imagine for 3 bedroom, Park Clementis itself has already got more than 480 units. It is already more than the total 4 bedroom we add up for these 4 condo here together. Having all this supply, I must say is still considered low compared to the demand in the market. Second factor, the consumer behavior. I will touch on the demand of the 4 bedrooms in this area. Being a place that has many good schools from primary school, secondary school, poly and university, I believe it will definitely draw a big demand for the bigger units in the market. As school is always many family top priority when come to choosing the housing location. If you notice, more profitable transactions for Clement Canopy and Trailing all come from the 4 bedrooms, which means these are the people that is more willing to pay for such a unit. How come this is the case? People who bought 4 bedrooms are usually buying for own consumption than for investment. So a big portion of this supply is already gone. And people who want to buy such units usually are big family that has difficulty finding interim houses for them to stay in between. Most people will bring a big family of Akong and Ama to rent a place for a few years, right? So with ABSD around, most of such family need to sell their current place, example a HDB, before they are able to buy the next property. So they are left with not much choices but buy from the limited units after deducting those that buy for own stay in the open market. And supply and demand come into the place again. That is when prices increase again. The third factor, the layout between competitors internally and externally. There is 3 different layouts in Claiborne for the 4 bedrooms. First one, compact 4 room, 1281 square feet. The other is 4 plus study, 1356 square feet. And the last one, a 4 bedroom premium, which is 1582 square feet. Actually, the 4 bedroom premium is almost 400k more expensive, which I think no matter how good the layout is, the gap is really too big to do a comparison together. So I will compare the 4 bedrooms and the 4 plus study in this case. In one look, you can see that the 4 bedroom and 4 plus study is very similar with only storeroom got dual access and an additional study room for the 4 plus study. But if you look into more details, the 4 plus study actually comes with a much bigger master room. This is very rare in the market and it will build up the buyer's future emotion and be more willing to pay. Having an extra study room can give us the flexibility of converting it into one more room. If not, it can be the wardrobe space for the Akong Ama that is staying with us. This gives us the additional benefit too. Most importantly, the price gap is not far between the 4 and the 4 plus study. All this make me choose the 4 plus study more if I have a choice. Compared to external competition, one thing I noticed about Claiborne is the layout of the living room. At Claiborne, it is portrait, and at Park Clementis, Clement Canopy, it is actually landscape. Something good about having landscape is it brings in a lot of natural light and it makes the whole place look a lot bigger. But one thing not so good about landscape is it comes with a very big balcony compared to portrait, and it can be easily double the size. And compared to trailing, to me, I must say, totally don't have to compare, because trailing's common room can only put in single size bed. I think queen size bed to many family is still a essential. The fourth factor, the price. With Claiborne, we are still able to get units below $1,500 per square foot at the point of time I took this video. Compared to Park Clementis, people are regularly doing it at $1,600 to $1,700 per square foot for the 4-bedroom. I think Claiborne price is still much more reasonable. And compared to Clement Canopy, people already doing at $1,005 per square foot for a 2-year-old condo. I think we are paying the same price for a brand new unit here is a no-brainer. And most importantly, it is from the same developer. As for trailing, yes, it is cheaper, $1,400 per square foot. But to me, I would say that it's too many things being compromised there, which I think most people won't consider even though it is cheaper. Advice for buyers who plan to buy a unit today. If possible, try to get the 4 plus study. Cause to most people, they might not mind being blocked by the HDB in front, but many future buyers will mind the noise from AYE. But of course, you need to pay attention to the final purchase price. I'm looking at these 2 points based on the available unit I see in the price list today. Decision might change if the overall price is too big in future. As for the owner who has already bought a unit here, take note of when you want to sell your unit for the best profit. Usually, 4 bedrooms are for own consumption. Don't sell immediately after TOP. Because at this point of time, you will still see many vacant units in the market and many owners have not decided what they want to do with the unit. Cashing out now might end up sell lower when competition is very, very high. Sell it when? 3 to 6 months down the road, if you can afford to hold on to it. This is when most of the own stay unit owner has already moved in. Those rental units already tenanted out. No longer available for buyers to buy and move in to stay immediately. And you will be the only unit that allow buyers to move in immediately. This is the time that they have to pay you the best price. Of course, Claiborne might not be the best choice for everyone. Everyone has their own unique preference, needs and wants. From a purely price analysis, Claiborne makes sense, but of course not suitable for all. If you are looking for more detailed analysis, customized solution, do contact me for further discussion. Remember, I'm here to bridge up the information gap between the market and the consumer. If there's certain project that you want us to review on, do leave a comment below. If you find our video useful, hit like and subscribe button. I'll see you soon. Bye!